Sox fan, and we will be watching the Keith Thurman Porter welterweight matchup. Live reaction. Testing this out, see how this is going to go. Fights on CBS, if you'd like to watch along. Anyhow, hope everyone's doing well on this Saturday evening. So, right now they're interviewing Deontay Wilder, a WBC heavyweight champion. He owns a portion of the title. So, we're waiting for the main event. Should be a good fight. Should be a good action fight. I don't know if anyone watched the Joshua Brazil fight this afternoon. But that was basically a replay of Larry Holmes, Randall Tex Cobb, except Brazil didn't go the distance. Joshua just pummeled Brazil and dropped him in the seventh and dropped him again, and they stopped the fight. After the first knockdown, Brazil's corner should have stopped it. So, alright, so it's going to be a little bit before the main event of Thurman versus Porter. Fights on CBS, free TV, should be a great fight. If you're a boxing fan, I highly recommend it. The first fight between Hurd and Molina was a very good fight also. Maybe a quick stoppage, but Molina wasn't going to win that fight anyway unless he knocked him out. So, and we're waiting for the main event. Hope everyone's Saturday is going well. I agree with him. I think it's going to be a 50-50 fight. I think it's going to be a very entertaining fight. So, Thurman the bigger puncher. Porter probably will throw more punches, but Thurman throws his fair share of punches also. All right, main event coming up. That's Thurman right there warming up. So, okay. Viewer, can you hear me? All right, we're waiting for the fight to start. And what are your thoughts on this fight coming up? Hopefully you're watching along. I don't think the stream is... Oh, we got it. Good work, live feed. Always the way forward. Yes! Batman Boxing, how you doing, buddy? Can you hear me? I'm just trying this through my PlayStation. Oh, thanks, buddy. Thanks. Awesome. Awesome. Yeah, so I just thought it'd be cool. I am getting some better equipment soon to actually do a better job of this. What did you think of the first fight, Batman? Oh, we got 5 viewers. Awesome. I apologize that it says Gauntlet, but like I said, I'm getting some new video equipment, and I hope to do a better job of this. But I do like boxing. I would love to chat with people. Is the fight going to be on here? No, no. I'm actually watching it on my TV, and I'm just going to chat away. I just thought that'd be pretty fun to do. So go to CBS. The fight's on free TV, CBS. Yeah, I liked the first fight. I thought Heard did very well. Quick hands, very tall, very rangy. Molina, tough guy. Molina's a tough guy. He just could never get in a rhythm, you know? Never could get in a rhythm. It was probably a quick stoppage, but he would have had to have knocked him out to win, you know? Just to touch base on the Joshua Brazil fight. That was not a quick stoppage, and if I was in his corner, I would have stopped that fight. I understand it's a championship fight, and okay, they let him go back out for the 7th. And, yes, I did. Yes, I did see that fight, Batman. I thought they should have stopped the Brazil fight after the first knockdown. If I was in the corner, I would have stopped the fight after the first knockdown. I understand it's a championship fight, but he was taking a beating. I honestly counted 3 solid punches he landed all fight. What are your thoughts, guys? What are your thoughts on the Joshua-Anthony Brazil fight? Yeah, very good. Very good. I've watched him on YouTube, you know, Batman. And that's the first time I saw him live. I missed him when he fought Crawford. I watched that fight on YouTube. He's a very good fighter. Very quick-handed. Good power. I honestly thought he... And he did... I mean, they were saying, oh, he should mix up his punches, Batman. But I thought he did a beautiful job just staying on the outside. Yes, Batman. Joshua was on another level. Absolutely. And I'd just like to thank you very much for joining me. That's awesome. And anyone else you'd like to jump in the chat, feel free. Who do you guys like in this fight, Batman? I think it's a very close fight. I'm giving a slight edge to Thurman, his punching power. And while we wait for the fight to start on CBS on free TV, just curious, who would you guys like to see if you did see the Joshua Brazil fight? Who would you like to see Joshua fight next? Would you like to see him fight David Haye? I think that huge fight in the UK. The UK just gets great crowds, great atmosphere. I love watching fights from there. Thank you for everyone who's joining in this little impromptu chat and watching the fight on CBS free TV. Hopefully you're all watching it. Hopefully everyone's doing well. Health and happiness to everyone. And so right now they're doing a little Thurman, showing him some highlights, as you're probably watching. Oh, good shot there. Alright, Batman Boxing says slight edge to Thurman also, but would not be surprised if Porter pulled it out. Sorry, Batman. Joshua, I would like to fight Joseph Parker next. Okay, cool. Great points, Batman. So right now, what time is it? Let's just take a look at the old clock, Eastern Standard Time. On the East Coast. 10:21. Alright. My guess is they're going to try to kill 9 more minutes and start this fight at 10:30 Eastern Standard Time. Oh yeah, they're going to kill 9 more minutes. Awesome crowd on hand. great crowd on hand for the Joshua Brazil fight. What are your thoughts on Batman? What are your thoughts on Tyson Fury and Klitschko fight coming up? Oh, all right. The fight's going to be starting. All right, any predictions from anyone else? So far, Batman and myself like Thurman, but also we wouldn't be surprised if Porter pulls it out. They're both very good fighters. I'd honestly like to see the winner of this fight Errol Spence. That'd be awesome. And if it was on free TV, it'd be awesome. So, a little more promo going on. So we're waiting for the fight and the promo. What are your thoughts, everyone out there, on... Hey, Rico Suave, how are you? You like Porter? I can see it happening. I think he'll throw more punches. I honestly do. I like both of these fighters. They're very enjoyable to watch. I'm very happy to see that they're fighting each other, and I hope it's a great fight. Hope no one gets hurt. You know, I mean, the usual boxing stuff, cuts, bruises, but no serious injuries. Let's just get a really good, hard fight. How's everyone doing out there tonight? Here comes Porter now. I hope this really does well. I like when they have boxing on the networks. It just does wonders for the sport, you know. Thank you once again for the people joining in. This was a really... I know it says I'm playing Gauntlet. I'm streaming my reactions through my PlayStation 4. And I hope everyone's watching the fight, and I'd love to get your guys' reactions to it also. So I appreciate people watching the fight along with me. Yep, streaming live here, right? Oh no, I'm watching, Rico, I'm watching on my television, and I will not be streaming the fight live. I'm streaming my reaction. So, if you're not watching, it will not be, I don't have the capability of streaming this live. So, anyone who's watching, please, the fight will not be on here. It's just my reaction. I'm watching, and I'll be giving my reaction to it. I don't want anyone to miss the fight. So, if you cannot see the fight and do this at the same time, please watch the fight. Okay? I don't want to misguide anyone. I'm just watching the fight and commenting on it and reading your comments over the air. So, thank you for everyone who's joining the live reaction of the fight. I'm not going to be streaming the fight once again. The fight is on CBS Network Free TV. So... And Thurman's coming into the ring now. I think this should be a really good fight. Rico Suave, were you able to... Did you see the Joshua Brazil fight? Batman and I were just discussing it a little earlier. All right, they're going to give us the tail of the tape now. Yeah, very similar. Yeah, Porter's going to want to put the pressure and try to get on the inside. Thurman likes to bomb away. All right, we're almost set for fight time. Jimmy Lennon Junior giving the announcement, as you guys are probably watching. Once again, anyone want to make some predictions? Batman and myself, we're picking Thurman. We give him a slight edge in this fight. Rico Suave has picked Porter. Would anyone else like to share their thoughts or predictions before the ringing of the first bell? Once again, thank you everyone for joining in the live reaction of we're going to be watching the fight together and having some reaction to it. The fight will not be streaming on here, just the reaction. The fight is on CBS TV, free TV. So if you cannot do this and watch the fight at the same time, please watch the fight. Here we go from Barclays Center. Showtime! All right. And they got an excellent crowd. Excellent crowd. Introducing Sean Porter right now. 26-1-1, 16 KOs. This should be, I believe this is going to be a really entertaining fight between Porter and Keith Thurman. So, I guess what we're going to do, if everyone would like to, let's score this round by round together. Let's be, we got 13 people now, in the, I guess we'll call it the chat. Let's score it round by round, you know? And let's see if we get it right. All right, they're going to introduce Keith Thurman right now. 26-0, one no decision, 22 KOs. Once again, this is... No, Hashish Ahmed, we are not playing Gauntlet. We're just watching the boxing match. So, that's what we're doing right now. Though Gauntlet is a fun game, do you play that? Alright. They're going in for the instructions right now. Alright, he's just telling them what's going to be a low blow. This should be a good fight. First bell coming up. Remember, go to CBS. You can watch the fight live. We're just as, this is just the live reaction show. We will not be streaming the fight. We are not playing Gauntlet. We're just making some comments on the boxing match. Thurman versus Porter, and we're set to go. And there we go. A little feeling out process right away. Oh, Thurman lands a jab to the body there. Oh! Nice hook. Some jabs by Porter. Oh! I think this is going to be a really good fight. Really good fight. Where can you watch the game or the fight, Ahmed? CBS. CBS, my friend. And if you're out of the country, do great app called Mobdro. You can go on YouTube and download it to your Android, and I'm pretty sure that streams CBS CBS Network. Oh, a lot of good action right now. So, good action in this first round. I think Porter's cutting the distance down, but Thurman has a slight advantage right now. What do you guys think? So, it's been a pretty good first round. Good action. Oh! Thurman tried to land a good right hand there. Porter's pressing. You like Thurman? Pasta? Yeah, myself and Batman Boxing, we picked Thurman. Rico Suave picked Porter. Do you think he's going to get a knockout, Pasta? Okay. You do think he's going to get a knockout. Yeah, he's looking good. Porter's not really... Oh. Well, I pressed a little bit there, but he's not really landing effectively. I give this round... I give round one to Thurman. Well, how did you guys see it? All right, we're at a commercial now. So, I give round one to Thurman. How did you guys score round one? Definitely thought Thurman controlled the action, landed the better punches. Also, feel free to share your thoughts if you guys watched the Joshua Brazil heavyweight fight. They will be replaying that on Showtime, I believe, at 11:30. So, and what fights are you excited that are coming up? All right, here we go, round two. Once again, thank you everyone for joining me in this live reaction of Thurman Porter fight. So far, Batman Boxing, myself, and Pasta Biceps, we've picked Thurman to win. Rico Suave has picked Porter to win. And I gave the first round to Thurman. I thought he controlled the action quite well. Porter hasn't really gotten into a rhythm yet. You think it's going to be an easy fight, Pasta? Oh, yes. Kovalev versus Ward. Yes, Pasta. Yes. That should be very good. Yes, that should be very good. Who do you like in that fight? I think Kovalev is a good puncher, but I think Ward's going to be his best opponent. I mean, Kovalev's kind of beat up on... Pascal twice. But he's a very good fighter. Very hard puncher. Very mean in that ring. Kovalev is very mean in that ring. So. Okay, Porter's pressing a little bit. Thurman's still... I think Thurman's landing the cleaner punches, though. Oh. A few good body punches there by Porter. He's got Thurman pinned on the ropes. Do you guys think Thurman's playing a little... Oh, a lot of good shots to the body there by Porter. Oh, low blow. Thurman's defense is pretty tight, actually. Now I'm... back of the head by Porter. I'd like to see Thurman get off those ropes. Oh, back of the head again by Porter. Did I miss? Was Thurman hurt? I didn't see him get hurt. It looked like he just backed to the ropes to me. I mean, Porter forced him there, but... Oh! Good combinations there. Ooh. Yes, Pasta. Absolutely. Did I miss something, Pasta? Because I was watching, and he... Oh, why is he back to those ropes again? I mean, I know Porter's there to win. Porter's a tough fighter. I like both of these fighters, actually. I don't know if he's trying to lure him into something like an uppercut. Porter's getting... He's a busier fighter. Oh, I think that uppercut landed. What do you guys think by Porter? I'm going to give that round to Porter. He pinned him to the ropes. I'm not saying he landed a lot of stuff, but he pinned him to the ropes. He threw a lot of punches, and he landed a few... He threw a lot, and he landed some. I'm going to give that round to Porter. What are your thoughts, gentlemen? Or ladies? Or viewers? Okay, Pasta Bicep says he should use the check hook like flow. Or use his footwork. Yes, I agree, Pasta. Use his footwork. I don't know why he went to the ropes. I didn't see him like he was hurt. You know, I don't know why Thurman went to the ropes. I don't know if he was playing possum and trying to catch him with something, but that was completely different than what he did in the first round. So if anyone saw something that myself that I didn't see, by all means share. I didn't think he was hurt, but maybe he was hurt to the body or something. Yes, Pasta, I agree. He's got to fight. Thurman has to fight more like he did in the first round. Okay, now he's backing up Porter. That was very strange second round he fought. I have it run one round apiece. I don't understand. Ooh, a couple of good body shots there. Yeah, he's got to stay away from the ropes. Definitely, Pasta. What is everyone else's thought? Because, I mean, Thurman, he likes to throw his punches at a little distance there because he likes to land the big punches. He got him in the corner now. They're going to break. Let's see if Porter tries to... Yep, jumped right back on him. I knew he was going to do that. Good shot there by Porter. Why is... Wow. Porter's really muscling him right now. Yep, absolutely, Pasta. Should definitely establish the jab like he did the first round. Oh, I think that was a pretty good body shot there by Thurman. Well, Porter right now is getting the distance he wants. He's able to get inside. I don't know. Did we all miss something? Was Thurman stunned? I didn't see it. Okay, there. Porter likes to move around a bit, and then he'll do his bum rush to get on the inside. Again. Get off the ropes, Thurman. Wow. We're missing something here. We must have missed something in that second round. Thurman seems a little discombobulated. Come on, Keith. Oh, we just missed with that uppercut. He must have... what do you guys think? He must have got stunned or just feeling Porter's strength. See those body punches? They were a little low, but... Okay, they're warning him. You know what? He's mugging him. I'm a little surprised here. I'm a little surprised that Porter... Again, once again, I like both of these fighters. They're two of my... I enjoy watching them box. Porter is really mugging him. He's wearing him down. Just pressuring him. It's kind of... I'm a little in shock here. Oh, another good body shot by Porter. Well, Rico Suave, if you're still watching along with us and chatting... Oh! Thurman nailed him! Oh, boy. Wow. Oh! Wow. Wow. Heavy punches there. Was that enough to win the round for Thurman? Yeah, Pasta. The body shots... You know, we missed something there, I think, buddy. In that second round... I'm going to give that round to Porter. He had most of the round. He had most of the round, in my opinion. So I'm going to give that one to quarter. But Thurman landed some big punches at the end of the third round. But right now I have it 2-1 for Porter. Once again, thanks everyone for... yeah, Batman, yes, big shot. Sorry, I hit the... I'm watching on my TV and I'm talking and reading through my Kindle. So I apologize if I miss anyone's messages. But yeah, that was a big shot, Batman. And if Rico Suave is still watching, Porter's looking pretty good. Okay, they're showing the replay here. Let's see, that was an overhand right. Oh, he took that shot. Wow. And left hand was a slap. Left hand was a slap. But I have it 2-1, Porter. Even with those big punch, the big punches at the end, I give it to Porter. And I agree with Pasta that those body punches are wearing him down. And I think he got hurt maybe to the body in the second round, Thurman, because he just stayed on those ropes and I missed it. And I was asking Pasta if he saw... Oh, another low blow by Porter. I really do like both these fighters. And I'd like to see the winner. I don't think they would do it. I'd like to see the winner of this fight fight Errol Spence, who destroyed Chris Algieri. Okay, see, Thurman's trying to box him. I really did under... Yes, Pasta. Me too. I'm not going to say... You know what? I'm not going to say we underestimated Porter. I'm always like the bigger punchers. I like Porter, but myself and Batman, and yourself too, Pasta, we picked Thurman. And hey, there's still a lot of fight to go. Still a lot of fight to go, people. Rico Suave, if you're still there, he did pick Porter. And right now I do have Porter winning 2-1. And he was wearing him down with the body shots. Pasta, really, Pasta, good point by you regarding the body shots, but he's just wearing him down. This is a little better round. Oh, get off the ropes, Thurman. Okay. Oh, yes, Errol. Very outstanding. I couldn't believe he destroyed Algieri. I thought that was going to be a close fight. I like Chris Algieri, and I'm going to be honest with you. I'm a Chris Algieri fan, but I honestly thought he beat Amir Khan. Oh, big shots there. Oh! Oh, wow. Wow. Oh, my God. Let's get back to this fight. I'm sorry, guys. I was going off. Oh, big right hand. Thurman coming on now. Oh, how much time we got here? 36 seconds? Oh, he missed with those. Oh, you know what? Porter's still pressing. But Porter's got to be careful because Thurman likes to fight at this distance. Because Thurman wants to catch him coming in. Oh! That was a go-home punch by Porter. You know what, though? Porter's gotten away from doing his body work, and that's what won him rounds 2 and 3. That's what won him rounds 2 and 3, and Porter got away from his body work there. And I'm going to give that round a close round, but I'm going to give that to Thurman. So I have it 2 rounds apiece. Porter got away from his body work, as Pasta Biceps so clearly pointed out that the body work was wearing... It seemed like it was wearing down Porter. I'm sorry, wearing down Thurman in rounds 2 and 3. I'm giving round 4 a close round, but I'm giving it to Thurman. I have it 2 rounds apiece. How do you guys see it out there? How do you guys see it? Just while they're in the break, go back to my Chris Algieri and Errol Spence point. Spence destroyed him and looked marvelous. And I honestly, I'm very impressed by Errol Spence in that win, because I honestly thought that Chris Algieri, had actually beat Amir Khan. Okay, let's see. Batman Boxing says, Thurman lands one big shot that round. I thought he landed two. I thought he landed a couple. Let's see some replays here. Left hook, and I thought he had a right hand there. That's the one that buckled him. So, Batman, who did you give that round to? Who did you give that round to, Batman? Pasta, who'd you give the round to? I have it 2 rounds apiece. Rico Suave, if you're still there, who'd you give the round to? And anyone else, share along. Okay. Round five here. This has been a... I've enjoyed this fight. Oh, I like Vasily... Lomachenko. I like him. Like him a lot. Was it last week or the week before? I watched the HBO fight. They had two fights go on HBO and Showtime, and I don't remember which one. I want to say he was on HBO because John Molina was fighting. Pasta, you gave that you gave the fourth round to Thurman? That's what I did. I have it two rounds apiece. It seems like they're taking a little break this round. But hey, it's been a good fight, entertaining fight. Okay. Thurman's keeping his distance now. Once again, thank you for anyone who's joining us in the live reaction to watching this fight on CBS. Porter and Thurman, we're enjoying ourselves. Myself, Pasta Biceps, Batman Boxing, Rico Suave. And anyone else, feel free to join in the chat. Everyone's welcome. So right now, myself and Pasta Biceps, we have it two rounds apiece, I believe. I don't know how Batman Boxing has it. Oh, Porter has him pinned on the ropes again. Porter's very strong. I thought that Thurman would be able to keep his distance better. Nah. Thurman, don't pose. Don't pose, Thurman. Let your hands go at distance. He's got to let those punches go. Oh, that was a decent body punch by Thurman. To the side. Another one. He's trying to load up. Thurman moving pretty good right now. Oh, two good shots. Two good shots by Thurman. Oh, he's finding his distance now. Thurman's finding his distance now, Pasta and Batman. That was a good little hook there to the body by Thurman. Could Porter be getting tired? I give that round to Thurman. I have it 3-2. How do you guys see it? Right now I have it 3-2 for Thurman. Batman, Pasta, how do you see it? Back to Pasta's point. He was asking what we think of Vasily Lomachenko. I think he's a very good fight. I mean, to be where he's at what, 6 professional fights? I mean, he had an incredible amateur career, and his hand speed, he's just an outstanding fighter. And that was a good win at the couple weeks back. Really good win. I can't remember the fighter, the Mexican fighter, the Puerto Rican fighter he beat. But it was by knockout, and he looked very sharp. Looked very good. What is everyone's feeling on the upcoming Tyson Fury Klitschko fight? I mean, to be honest with you, I did pick Fury in the first fight, but it really was a boring fight. I mean, that's a good shot. They're showing some replays here, as you can see, Porter. But I still give that round to Thurman. I have it 3-2. So we're on to round 6, and let's enjoy. Once again, feel free to share your thoughts. Thurman's pressing a bit. Okay, Pasta Bicep says, do you think that... Do you think... I'm sorry, I'm trying to read... Do you think... Oh, Ragone. I can't pronounce that guy's name. I know who you mean. I'm sorry, Pasta. I can't... Yeah, he's a good fighter. You like Fury in the win. So you like Fury in the rematch, Pasta? I just hope he's a little more active. In that fight, in the rematch with Klitschko. He won the first fight, and I picked him to win the first fight, but it was really a dull fight. So. Porter getting on the inside again. Oh. Porter just doing some good work right there. Rigo. Thank you, Pasta. Rigo. He's a very good fighter. Porter's doing a good job right now. So, Thurman's got to stay off those ropes. Good body shot there by Porter. Good uppercut by Porter. Well, Porter's winning this portion of the round. Thurman really hasn't landed anything. Those body shots, what do you think? Pasta and Batman boxing. This is a Porter round so far. Got about a minute left. Yeah, I agree with you, Pasta, that first Tyson Fury Klitschko fight was boring. Klitschko really didn't throw many punches in that fight. But if you get inside on the Klitschkos, they don't want to fight. But ooh, good body shots there by Porter. Again, Thurman on the ropes. Thurman on the ropes. You got to get off the ropes. What do we got, about 36 seconds here? I'm giving this round, unless something tremendous happens in these last 30 seconds, to Porter. Absolutely, Pasta. Absolutely, I agree. He's got to start countering those body shots, yep. Oh! He just missed there. Or if he did, he grazed him. Obviously, he didn't land solid. There was no real reaction by Porter. Well, I have it 3 rounds apiece. How do you guys have it out there? Once again, thank you very much for joining us. Myself, Pasta Biceps, Batman Boxing. We're here we're not all here. I mean, we're wherever we are watching the fight, but we're all commentating and chatting away. Yes, Batman Boxing, it is a good fight. This fight's a lot better than some of the crap pay-per-views they've been putting on. So, how do you see it, Batman Boxing? I have it 3 rounds apiece. Pasta, how do you see it? Alright, they're just telling them to, Porter to, throw the overhand right. Porter for this round. Yep, I had him for that round too, Pasta. Alright, here we go. Round 7. Hope everyone's enjoying this. You think so, Batman? I love Lomachenko, so I try not to. I'm pretty biased about him. I just think it's incredible. Such a great amateur and what he's done in the few fights he's had as a pro. And Pasta Bicep. Porter, you're saying you gave Porter the last round? So do we all have it even? Is that how we're seeing it? That's how I'm seeing it. Thank you, everyone, for joining us as we're watching. That's okay. We got some... Hey, the unofficial scorers have it even. So, hey, we're not doing too bad. Now we'll see if the 3 blind mice have it at the end of the fight, if it goes that far. Now Porter's pressing. This is a role reversal again. It seems every couple of rounds it changes, which makes for an entertaining fight. Ah, man. Porter digs those little shots to the body. When I say little, I don't mean like they don't hurt, but he just digs those shots to the body, and that's going to wear you down. You know? Oh, that was a good shot there. Yep. Thurman, he should have let his right hand... Oh, he's got a little puffiness on his eye. Oh, letting his hand go there. Porter's nice... That was a nice, cute move by Porter. He spun him right to the ropes. You guys see that? And he's really... Porter's strong. Which fight, regardless of who wins, which fighter would you like to see fight Errol Spence? I'd like to see them all fight in a round robin. I think that'd be great, round robin tournament. I think it'd be great for TV and for boxing. I like Porter so far in this round. It's about a minute. Oh! Was that a slip or a knockdown? Slip, okay. I thought I couldn't tell. Yep. We got, what, 42 seconds left in this round. Once again, thank you everyone for joining us. Myself, Batman Boxing, Pasta Biceps, Rico Suave. Ooh, Danny Garcia! He's a good... yes. Yes. Do you think these guys are too big for Danny Garcia, though? This is definitely a Porter round. Definitely Porter round. What do we got here? About 17 seconds. Why is it blocking the time? Is that doing it on your guys' TV? Or however you're watching it? I cannot see the clock on the bottom. It has the round thing is blocking it. 4 seconds left. I give that round to Porter. 4-3 Porter. Danny Garcia is a very good action fighter. I do... See, okay. I understand... Floyd Mayweather is a great fighter and a Hall of Fame fighter, but as a boxing fan, I greatly appreciate his boxing abilities and everything he can do, and he's one of the greatest fighters of all time, but as a fight fan, his fights are pretty boring, and not through any fault of his own, well, some of it. There are times where I thought he could be more aggressive, but... So, Danny Garcia, very TV-friendly fighter. Porter, very TV-friendly fighter. Thurman, very TV-friendly fighter. And that's what you have to put on TV, especially on free TV, if they're trying to, in my opinion, get more boxing fans. You got to put the TV-friendly fighters on, such as a Turo Gotti, God rest his soul, or, well, I mean, were his fights with Mickey Ward were absolutely unbelievable action fights. Were they the two greatest fighters? No, but they were very fun to watch. Yeah. See that? Thurman on that replay missed both of his and Porter. So how do you guys have it after 7? I have it 4-3 Porter. Thank you everyone for joining myself, Pasta Biceps, Batman Boxing, Rico Suave if you're still here. Thank you for joining us as we're watching the fight in our locations and just chatting away about it. Appreciate everyone showing up. Share your thoughts with us. Oh, Porter's got a little redness and puffiness around that eye. Do you guys see that? I know boring's not the right word. I just... He was so good. And God bless him, because he is one of the best. And he made good fighters look ordinary. You know? So... Yes, Oscar is pretty exciting, I agree. There goes Porter again with that little... That good work he does on the inside. Now, Thurman's pressing a bit. So... This has been a good fight. Very enjoyable to watch. Ooh! Little combination there. Once again, thank you for joining the live reaction chat we're having on the Thurman Porter fight. Myself, Pasta Biceps, Batman Boxing. Oh! Porter's pouring it on here. He's killing him to the body. Porter is good, tough fighter, Porter. Good, tough fighter. Both these guys are very enjoyable. Oh. The one thing I did say to a couple of my friends at work was, Thurman sometimes doesn't throw, in my opinion, enough punches. But again, I'm not going to... I did pick Thurman to win. Oh. He's got to turn the tide here, Thurman. He's got to land something big. Oh, he almost caught him there. He caught him with a left hook there. But Porter's doing an excellent job. What do we have here left in this round? We have about 13 seconds. And again, I think this is... Oh, he caught him! It's a Porter round. Still a Porter round. Yep. I give that round to Porter. I have Porter up by 2 rounds now. How do you guys see it? Batman, Bicep, how do you guys see it? And anyone else who'd like to share? Alright, here comes a replay. Oh, crunching body shot right under the elbow, in the ribs, above the belt. Yeah, painful. More play-by-play and less reaction. Well, I don't want to... I mean, are you watching productions? I mean, I can try to do play-by-play. I mean, if you're not... If no one's watching, I agree with you. I'm not really doing play-by-play. But I appreciate the comment. I will do a little more play-by-play. I will try my best. All right, we're on to round 9 here. Both fighters come out to the center of the ring. Oh, you're not watching. Okay, production. I will try to do a little play-by-play. We're in round 9 here. I have it, Porter up by 2 rounds. Right now, Thurman is pressing a little bit. Porter's back of... Porter touched the ropes. Now, Porter's pressing the fight, and he's backing Thurman to the ropes, and this has been where Porter's done a lot of good body work. Porter's going to the body again. Thurman's circling away. Thurman is not throwing enough punches right now. Porter's jabbing his way in. He's on the inside. He hit him once with his free hand as they tie up. The referee breaks them. Porter, they're back at distance. Now, Thurman's trying to press, but not really doing it. Porter, they're circling. They're just circling, posing a bit. Jabbing. Now they fall into a clinch again. I don't know how to do that, Pasta. You know, I'm sorry about that. I apologize. I apologize. You know, next time I... Again, this was a oh! Couple of good body shots there by Thurman. This was a quick thing I decided to do. I'm going to be much better when I get my real equipment. So I'm sorry for the music. I will... Oh, good combination there by Thurman. He's pressing. Oh! Oh, Porter! There was an exchange of punches, and I think Porter got the better of it. He has Thurman pinned on the ropes. He's bobbing. He's weaving. Not really landing anything. Neither fighters are kind of mauling right now. Wow. That was a good combination, both of them, but I think Porter got the better of it. I'm sorry, Pasta. I'll do a better job next time. I didn't realize the... I apologize for that. So, they're back to the center of the ring. 60 seconds left in round 9 production. Porter's pressing him a little bit, landed a couple little body shots. Hello, Papa Bang. Oh! Porter has him back on the ropes again. I'm sorry, Porter has him, Thurman back on the ropes. Porter banging away to the body. Oh, left hook by Porter. Porter has Thurman pinned on the ropes. Thurman trying to hold on, Porter just banging away. I'm telling you right now, my pick of Thurman does not look really good right now. Porter's just wearing him down, beating him down. Oh, Porter just threw a haymaker. And missed, though. I feel that, Papa Bang, I feel that... Oh, Porter has him pinned on the ropes again! He's banging away! Thurman could be hurt! Oh, he's banging away! Porter has him pinned on the ropes, banging away! Erica says hi. Hello, Erica. That was a huge round for Porter. He's starting to take total control of this fight now. I hope you're doing well, Erica. Thurman looks... what do you think, Pasta and Batman Boxing? Thurman looks dead tired on that stool. I think Porter's breaking him down round by round. My pick, our pick doesn't look too good right now. Rico Suave's pick looks real good. So, I apologize for the... I'm going... Papa, you're going... Well, I picked Thurman also, Papa. Poppy, I'm sorry. Poppy. I picked Thurman. Pasta Biceps picked Thurman. Batman Boxing picked Thurman. Rico Suave picked Porter. I don't know who production picked, but I'm gonna be doing some play-by-play because production is not watching along, and so I'm just gonna be doing play. I apologize for the background music. All right, here comes round 10, and to me, Porter's taking total control of this fight. Both fighters are out in the center of the ring now, just sort of pawing. You're welcome, production. Both fighters are just pawing. They're circling each other. And this has been the MO in the beginning of the rounds. Porter start... Oh! Thurman does not look steady, guys. What are your thoughts on that? They're still in the center of the ring. Wow, the unofficial scoring only has Porter up by one round. Did I see that right? Did I see that right, guys? I don't agree with that. Thurman's pressing the fight now. Porter got him pinned on the ropes again! And he's pounding away. Thurman comes back with a combination off the ropes, but Porter, they're able to clinch, and Porter keeps him on the ropes. Referee breaks him. They move to the center of the ring. I like Danny Garcia too, Poppy. Good action fighter, good TV fighter. We were talking about that. Thurman's trying to get back in this jabbing. Just pawing with it, as the announcer said. I agree. I think Thurman's looking to set up a big punch. Oh, see those? Even those awkward body punches are really effective for Porter. Porter came with an overhand right. That was a glancing blow. Oh! Good combination by Thurman. That could have rocked Porter just a little bit. Porter backing up. Now he's not. Oh, leaped in with a left hook. Porter did. But they didn't really do anything. Okay. Poppy, can you check that scorecard? Did I see that right? Oh, Thurman just missed with a right hand. And now Porter has him pinned on the ropes. Flailing away, Porter is. Porter is a strong fighter. He's just mauling him. He's mauling him. I agree, Pasta. I think... Porter's mauling him on the ropes. He is mauling him on the ropes. I agree with Pasta Biceps. I believe Thurman has to go for a KO here, but... and we'll discuss in between rounds, so I'm going to do the play-by-play for production. Okay, they're back at distance right now. Porter throws a couple of jabs. One might have landed. Thurman's a little puffy around the underneath the left eye, I believe. Thurman missed with both those punches. Porter's pressing him. Oh, there was a punch landed! There was a punch landed! Thurman trying to load up now. What do you think, Pasta? Oh, man. Oh, now Porter! Oh, Porter has him pinned on the ropes! Hit him with a couple of good shots. Thurman looks hurt to me. And there's the bell. Wow. I give that round to Porter. I still give that round to Porter. And I picked Thurman. Believe me, I'd love to give the round to Thurman, but I can't. Marlin, thank you for joining us. Marlin says he lost to Peterson to me. Okay. Okay, Papa Bank says, mark my word, if it goes to the scorecards, Thurman will win. It's politics. If it goes to the scorecards and he wins, when I have Porter up, we're going into round 11. I have Porter up by four rounds. I'm trying to go through my head real quick with the rounds. Yeah, four rounds, I believe. He needs a knockdown to get back in the points. I believe Porter. So let's all, if they show the unofficial scoring, guys, let's just all pay attention to that, because I think, if I saw it right, I thought they had Porter by one round. And I don't see that. Do you guys see that? And I picked Thurman. Did you bet on the fight? I wish I did. Actually, I'm glad I didn't. No, I didn't. Okay, so we're on to round 11. It's been a very fun fight, and thank you very much for everyone who's joined in. I hope we're all enjoying this together. So, thank you very much. I'm going to do a little play-by-play again for production, who is not able to watch the fight. They're in the center of the ring. Once again, they're just pawing, moving around. Not a lot of action going. Okay, what do we have here? What do we have? They have Thurman ahead! Are they crazy? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Do you guys have Thurman ahead? I don't. Wow. Farhood's on drugs. Farhood's on drugs. There's no way Thurman's ahead and I picked him. All right, they're back in the center of the ring again. Nothing's really happening right now in production. They're just moving around. They've exerted a lot of energy. It's been a very entertaining fight. Nothing really going on here. Missed combination by Porter. Just circling. Porter landed a body shot. Now he's mauling him again. He's really done a job mauling him, where he just wrestles him and bends him down and presses on his neck. Porter's getting a little wild. Wow, they have Thurman up by 2 points. I don't see it. You're right, Poppy. That's unofficial. You're absolutely right. This is a... Thurman landed a good counter left hook as he was backing up, but that might have took some of the power out of it. Now, Porter's pressing him. I'm telling you, if I was Porter, he's fought a wonderful fight. He's got to go for it, because they're going to screw him out of this decision. I agree with Poppy. Pasta, I mean, do you see... We picked Thurman, but I'm being honest with you. He's not winning the fight. And Pasta said those judges got to be playing. Oh, Porter just missed a wild overhand right, production. There again. If I'm telling you, Porter's got to press. I have him up by 4 rounds, and the unofficial scorer has him as Thurman up. That's bullshit. All right, back to... they're really not doing much this round. There was a little action. Thurman's trying to... Porter's pressing him. Nothing's really landed. Okay, Poppy. Trust me, the politics of boxing is leaning towards Thurman. I agree, but it's not right. I love boxing, and I hate when this happens. Vicious body shot by Porter. He's got to let it go. You know, I think it was Thurman who needs the knockout to win. But the way the unofficial scorer has it, it's going to be Porter who needs the knockout to win. That's ridiculous, you know? Poppy says it's all about who lands the cleaner shots. Yes, it is, but I honestly think Porter's winning the fight. Oh, that was a nice... That's the count. That's the hook when he was backing up a bit. If he was coming forward with that, would have done a lot more damage by Thurman. So. All right, here comes the last round. Once again, thank you for everyone who's joined myself, Pasta Biceps, Poppy Bang, Batman Boxing, Rico Suave. They've all... Poppy Bang says it's not right at all, but be realistic. It's the way it is. Yes, it is, Poppy. You are correct. And we're all boxing fans, so we know it. But I just... All right, here comes the last round, guys. It's been a very entertaining fight. I'm glad you guys, everyone's joined us. We're having a good time here. So let's see how this goes. All right, I'm going to go back to a little play-by-play for production. I apologize if it's not good production. I didn't expect to be doing play-by-play. So, all right, they're in the center of the ring. Porter throws a couple of punches, doesn't land anything. Thurman throws. Oh, Porter backs him to the ropes. But Thurman gets off the ropes. Nothing was really landed by Porter. There's still... I think Thurman's trying to load up here. All right, unofficially. Wow. Unofficially, they got Thurman up by 3 points. I don't see it. I just don't. I really don't. Maybe I don't even see him winning the last round. I thought that was even. You could have maybe gave it to him, but still. Oh! Porter landed a pretty good shot there. He's got him like in a headlock. Now the ref makes some break. There's still Porter backing a bit. Thurman looking to land to something big here. Porter throws a couple of punches. Nothing really going on. They're both moving around. Thurman's looking to land a big punch. Land a little slap hook there. Shout out to Poppy Bang. Subscribe to his channel. So jump on his channel and subscribe, everyone. And if you'd like, subscribe to my channel. But yeah, if anyone has anything they'd like for me to shout out, that'd be awesome. Porter's pressing the fight right now. Not a lot of clean punches landing this round. Both fighters, it's been a very entertaining fight. They're both tired. It looks like Thurman's looking to land something big. Oh, that left uppercut didn't land. If it landed, Porter wouldn't be pressing him on the ropes right now. These guys are silly. Porter has him pinned to the ropes, and they're both flailing away. Porter, I'm going to be honest with you. I feel that Porter mugged him in this fight. I have Porter winning this fight, but I'm probably going to be wrong. And I picked Thurman, so if Thurman wins, I guess I'm right. But I don't think he won the fight, to be honest with you. I missed something here. I apologize. I missed a message here. Oh! Thurman landed a little punch behind the head. Now they fall into a clinch in the center of the ring. We have 22 seconds left in this fight production. They're clinching. They're mauling. 15 seconds left. And they're just mauling and punching away, holding and hitting. It's been a very entertaining fight. This was a good, good fight to watch. I have Porter the winner. I picked Thurman, but I feel I am incorrect. So, all right, let me read some comments here. And thank you, everyone, for joining us. Ferdinand, is there any way we can see the actual video of the announced decision? I am not capable to do that. I apologize. I will give you the decision. Pasta, yeah, please. I wish I could. I don't have the equipment to do that right now. This was an impromptu thing. I just decided to do it to try it out to see if anyone would jump in. And it's been a lot of fun. I thank all you guys for jumping in. Papa Bank, thank you very much. Hey, everyone, if you want, check out my channel. I do some gaming. I'm not really good at it. But I do some gaming. But I do some fantasy boxing matches where I simulate them through Title Bout Boxing. And if you're boxing fans, and you can, I recommend picking up Title Bout Boxing. It's a fun simulation. And I do my play-by-play calls for that. But anyway, Batman, wonderful. Thank you for joining. And let's... I'm going to be honest. I picked Thurman, but I think Porter won the fight. Batman Boxing, what a fight that was. Both elite fighters, respect to both. Absolutely, I totally agree, Batman. Papa Bang. Shout out to Papa Bang. Subscribe to me, he asks. Papa Bang. Then he says, this guy is awesome. Oh, thank you, if you mean me. And if you don't, that's fine, too. Thank you. Oh, Batman Boxing, thank you. Thank you very much. Did you guys find this fun? Ferdinand, that's okay, but thank you very much for... Okay. Ferdinand says, thank you... Oh, sorry. That's okay. Thank you very much for the live reaction video. Pasta Biceps, thank you, Al. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. I'm going to get better at this. I just... My brother-in-law works for ESPN, and he has some software and some other things, an extra camera. They're going to probably have a lot of this stuff quickly up on YouTube. That's the way I follow a lot of fights from Europe. Oh, guys, Mobdro is a great app. It's spelled Mobdro. Go on YouTube, type in Mobdro, and watch how you download. It's really quick. You can download it to an app. And again, be careful when you're using apps like this. But there's a ton of sports channels you can stream for free. Unbelievable, guys. Hey, production. I'm glad you like my probably crappy play-by-play. I appreciate that. So, Mobdro, everyone. MOBDRO.com. Go on there, check it out. You can download. Okay, here comes the decision by Jimmy Lenny Jr. I'll call it out to you guys, okay? Close but unanimous decision, he says. All three judges, they all scored about the same. 115-113. Keith Thurman 115, 113, all three judges scored it the same. I'm going to be honest. Yes, Pasta, Mob Dro. Check it out. It was a close... I'm going to be honest. I picked Thurman. Pasta picked Thurman. Batman picked Thurman. Rico Suave picked Porter. And I don't know how else all the other people saw it who have joined us on this reaction show. I thought Porter won. Am I happy that my pick's right? Yeah, sort of, but I thought Porter won. Porter did get robbed. It was all three judges had it scored, everyone. All three judges had it scored 115, 113 for Thurman. Thurman is the winner. Thurman is the winner. 115, 113. All three judges had saw it that way. Close but unanimous. Pasta, it's boxing, you know. I agree. I thought Porter won, you know. And it's funny because you and I and Batman Boxing, we had Thurman. I mean, we're right, but yet we're a little upset. And I like both these guys. I like both these guys. It was a very good fight, Batman. Very good fight. Very good fight. Did you guys enjoy this? Would you like to do it again? Should we do it again? I'm going to try to get better equipment and do this better. I would like to see a rematch. I would like to see a rematch. Yes, I would like to see a rematch. Thurman's being very classy. He's saying how it was a tough fight. So he gave credit to Porter. Oh, he has a cut. I did not know that. Do you guys see that cut? He has a cut over his eye. Nasty cut. But the cut men did a great job on that. I didn't even notice it. I'd like to see a rematch. I would. Once again, thank you every... Oh, now they're going to talk with Porter. Porter and Thurman are shaking hands. Great sportsmanship. Two great warriors. Great sportsmanship. This is what boxing's about. Porter says he's blessed to have these fans. And Porter's being classy also. Stream Frampton versus Cruz. You mean... do a reaction show to that? You guys want to do a reaction show to that? Live reaction? Oh, they're talking rematch. They're talking rematch. I'd love to see it on CBS. Let's do it. Let's see the rematch. The fans enjoyed it. We enjoyed it. This is what boxing's about, except for the decision. I thought Porter won. Again, myself, Pasta Biceps, Batman Boxing, we all picked Thurman. Rico Suave picked Porter, and I honestly think Porter won the fight, in my opinion. But I like both these guys. All three judges had it 115, 113 unanimous for Thurman. I wonder if they're going to give us some punch stat numbers. So let's, I'm going to go a little longer with this. So, hey, guys, what, just feel free to send any questions that if you'd like to, I'll read them out. And maybe the people left in the chat, there's 16 people watching, we can all comment on. And so, oh, Al Bernstein just said he thought the scoring was fair. I don't agree with him, and I like Al Bernstein, but I don't agree. I thought Porter won. That's just my opinion. So... now they're going to go back up to Brian Custer, who is like the studio show. So this was a really good card. I enjoyed both fights. Were you guys able to see the first fight between Hurd and... oh, what was the general? Oh, yeah, was it... Molina sticks in my head. Is that right? I believe it was named Molina. That was a good fight. Hurd was very impressive. It was a quick stoppage, but that's all right. So, okay, Thurman's leaving the ring. It was a great evening of boxing, everyone. Thank you very much for joining. I'm going to stay on a little bit longer if you guys would like to chat away about boxing. Okay, Pasta Biceps says, got to give credit to Thurman. Landed some nice sharp shots. He did land some good shots. I'm not discrediting Thurman. as you know, Pasta, because we picked him. You know, I honestly thought Porter won. You know, Porter was strong on the inside, and he mugged him. He mauled him and brawled him. You know? So, if you enjoyed this, check out my channel if you'd like. Subscribe if you'd like. Share if you like. Trying to grow my YouTube channel. I'd also, if you guys have YouTube channels, I'm more than happy to help you guys out as much as possible when, you know, tweeting out your stuff. So we're all in it together, I guess. So, but anyhow, just came on. They're showing some highlights now. I did really enjoy this fight. This was CBS's first live boxing primetime event in, I think they said, 40 years. Muhammad Ali versus Leon Spinks was the last one, the first fight when Leon Spinks upset Muhammad Ali. So, also, if you're boxing fans, and as you probably know, check out YouTube. Punch in. There's a lot of great old fights on there. I recommend, if you haven't seen the first Muhammad Ali Joe Frazier fight, the fight of the century from Madison Square Garden, check it out on YouTube. Very entertaining. Very entertaining, in my opinion. Oh, Pasta, thank you. Thank you for subbing. I appreciate that. Guys, I'm also on Twitter, Al Red Sox fan, if you tweet. If there's anything, you know, you want to tweet out to me, I will retweet it. You know, so I appreciate that. Thank you very much. I think we had some fun here, and I'd like to do this again. I'd like to do this a little more professionally as opposed to doing this through PlayStation. And unfortunately, having the gauntlet music in the background that Pasta pointed out, I should have muted it. I don't even know how to mute it, but I'll try to get better and better at this. I just tried it out. I really love boxing, and I'm just trying to connect with people who love boxing, and I connected with some really nice people today. Pasta Biceps, Rico Suave, Ferdinand, Production, Batman Boxing. So thank you all very much. It was very fun. At one point, I believe we had about 19, 20 people viewing along with us. So that was kind of cool. I tried to read out your messages, and if I missed some, I apologize. But anyhow, thank you very much, everyone. It was fun. I'm going to stay on just a little bit longer. If you'd like, whoever's left... Hey, Production. Thanks, buddy. What? How do you guys feel that we're not going to get the Triple G Canelo Alvarez fight? I mean, that's a fight I'd like to see. I think Triple G would be the favorite in that fight. Because he's a good fighter, but they're both good fighters. But it sucks that you don't get that fight, you know? Now, I guess Triple G is going to go to England. There's possible talk of him and Chris Eubanks Jr. So, what are your thoughts on that? Do you think Canelo Alvarez is ducking Triple G? Like I said, I'm going to stay on just for a little bit longer. I don't know who's left with me. So, I see Pasta had sent a message. Production had sent a message. So, it looks there's 8 people viewing. 7 now. I'm losing them. Anyhow. Well, just a quick recap. It was a very entertaining fight. I honestly thought Porter won. Production. Production says, that sucks, Canelo. Disappointed me for not taking it. I agree. I mean, that's what made Roberto Duran... and Tommy Hearns and Sugar Ray Leonard and Marvin Hagler, they fought everybody, you know. Even Floyd Mayweather Jr. fought everybody, you know. I mean, there might have been some hims and haws about ducking Pacquiao, but I mean, he pretty much fought everybody. Again, but you got to have the great fighters have to fight each other, you know. Sugar Ray Robinson and Jake LaMotta fought... What would they fight? 5 times? I mean, Jake LaMotta used to make the joke, I fought Sugar Ray so many times I have diabetes. I would have really liked to see the Canelo Alvarez Triple G fight. Now they're talking Triple G going, I believe he would go to Europe, to England, to fight Chris Eubanks Jr. And actually, that would be a fun fight in the UK, because in the UK, the fight fans are unbelievable. The atmosphere, just like with Mexican fight fans, unbelievable. I mean, there's great fight fans here, too, in the US, but the atmosphere in the UK for the Joshua and Brazil fight was outstanding. You know, in a fight that was basically Joshua beating up on a human punching bag. So, that's the fight I really wanted to see, was Triple G and Canelo Alvarez. Well, I think on that note, everyone, thank you very much for checking me out. And if you enjoyed, check out my channel. If you'd like, subscribe. Oh, hello, Zach. Triple G will just... I'm not disagreeing with you. I agree. I just think the atmosphere, if they went to fight in the UK, would be unbelievable. Huge. If they fought in a stadium, they'll get a huge crowd. That's just my belief. Chris Eubanks Jr. is very popular. His dad was a popular fighter, as you probably know. But I do think Triple G would win that fight. He's really fun to watch. Another very fan-friendly fighter, you know. Also, oh God, what's the, there's another middleweight, English middleweight, Saunders, is that his name? There's also talk of that fight, but I think the more enthusiasm would be for Chris Eubanks Jr., Triple G and Chris Eubanks Jr. Zach, who would you like to see Triple G fight next? I would like him to fight Canelo Alvarez, but Alvarez doesn't want to make that fight, or his promoters don't want to make that fight. Oh, Zach says, I agree, I'm from the UK. Oh, hello, Zach. From the UK. Yeah, you guys are great fight fans. I try to, if I can't stream them on my computer, the fights, or if they're not on, you know, US TV, I wait for someone to post them on YouTube. I really enjoy it. Thank you, Billy Joe Saunders, yes. What are your thoughts on him, Zach? I've watched some fights of his on YouTube. I did not see the Andy Lee fight, and I didn't see it on YouTube yet, but from what I read, it was not too exciting. Saunders, from what I saw, has, I believe, a good left hook. Doesn't throw enough punches. And he beat Chris Eubanks Jr., am I correct? I believe that is correct, that he beat Chris Eubanks Jr. Zach, Billy Joe Saunders. So, either one. Zach says, I would love to see Triple G versus... Oh, that's a good fight, too, against Laura. That would... Yes. Yeah. What about this? What about this? Triple G moving up to light heavy to fight Kovalev. Regardless of if Kovalev and whoever wins that fight, Ward. That would be a very interesting fight. Yes, okay, I am correct. It's a little late here in the... It's actually... what's it around? 11:30 here, so... So who do you think, Zach? Zach says Billy Joel Saunders destroyed Eubanks, and he did. Zach, who do you think would have a better shot at Triple G? Would it be Billy Joel Saunders or Chris Eubanks? And that being said, Zach, who would draw more excitement for that fight? I think it would be that they'd be more excited for the Eubanks fight, Zach. So, but yeah, that'd be interesting to see Triple G and Kovalev. And Kovalev's one mean dude in that ring. I assume, Zach, you watched the Joshua fight today. So, anyone who's viewing this right now, we were doing a live reaction show to the Keith Thurman, Sean Porter fight. Spoiler alert, I will count to 10 before I give what happened, the winner and stuff. I don't know if you guys want to watch on YouTube, so, or elsewhere. Spoiler alert, I'm going to count to 10 and then give the results of the Thurman Porter fight. So if you don't want to hear it, mute me. I'm counting to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I will now give the result of the Thurman Porter fight. Thurman won on all three judges' scorecards, a unanimous close decision, 115 to 113. I had picked Thurman. Batman Boxing had picked Thurman. Pasta Biceps had picked Thurman. Rico Suave picked Porter. These are people who are watching along with me through the chat. I honestly thought Porter won the fight. Okay, that, enough of that then. Zach sends a message. I think Billy Joe Saunders has the same fan base as Fury, but Eubank has the national support. Okay, thank you for that, Zach. I appreciate the information. Zach also says, I will complete is overrated. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to read your message, Zach. Bear with me a moment. Because I'm doing this through my PlayStation 4, so it chops up. I will be completely honest. I think Joshua is overrated and is on some steroids. Now, don't they do drug testing? I know that usually they can stay ahead of that, but he does look sharp. Now, I neither of those two fighters had really fought. Joshua and Brazil really fought top-notch competition. I think Joshua fought a little better competition than Brazil. Brazil was slow. I could not believe how slow he was. I watched a little bit of him before. I knew he was slow. I just couldn't believe how slow he was. He was a human punching bag. So it reminded me of Randall Tex Cobb versus Larry Holmes, except that Randall Tex Cobb went the full 15 rounds, you know. So, hey, quick question to anyone from the UK, and I know Zach's from the UK, and thank you very much for joining us, and thank you, Zach, for participating with chatting. David Price, he had a comeback fight, a month ago, a few weeks ago? I believe he won. What are your thoughts on him? I know his chin is suspect. Well, it is suspect. But, Zach says, Thurman versus Garcia will be amazing. Would be a very good action fight. Do you think Thurman would be too big for... You know, Zach, that you brought that fight up, Thurman versus Garcia. Thurman would be the bigger puncher, in my opinion. But I think Garcia has a higher work rate, and he's a tough son of a gun. They're both tough son of a guns. That would be a good fight. And seeing what I saw tonight in the Thurman Porter fight, I believe if Garcia, but though he would be the smaller man, Porter's really strong. I'm wondering if Garcia could do the same thing to Thurman that Porter did. But yeah, that would be a very good fight, Zach. So, for all the people joining us right now, this is I was doing a live reaction show of the Keith Thurman Sean Porter fight. It's over now. I'm sure someone will post that on YouTube if you haven't seen it. If you want, I can give the result of it if you message, and then I'll count to 10 and say, you know, so no one who hasn't seen the fight and doesn't want to know won't be disappointed. So, anyhow, I'm going to go for a little bit longer. I'm chatting with Zach from the UK. We're doing some just bouncing stuff off of, you know, about boxing. I do enjoy the fights from the UK. Great atmosphere. I'm just trying. We were talking a little bit about Triple G and how Canelo Alvarez are not going to fight. Oh, Zach sends another message. What do you think of Lomachenko? I love Lomachenko. Lomachenko, if I pronounce that correctly. Amazing fighter. Amazing. Amazing fighter, Zach. What are your thoughts? I mean, for a stellar amateur career, and what does he have? 7 fights? Pro fights? And to be honest, he should be undefeated. He won that fight. Oh, God. Oh, what was that guy he fought and he lost the decision to? And because he just fought, too. I'm drawing a blank. I apologize for that. I love Lomachenko. Great fighter. Just outstanding. I do like him a lot. Entertaining. Zach, because you had said that Billy Joe Saunders has the same fan base as Tyson Fury, what are your thoughts, Zach, on Tyson Fury and Klitschko 2? In the first fight, I did pick Fury. I was happy he won, but it was a boring fight. Do you think Fury will... I mean, all credit to Fury. He did what he did. Had to do. He won the fight because he said he was going to frustrate him, and he did. And Klitschko can make all the excuses he wants. He lost that fight, and he didn't throw punches. So I'm just curious, what is everyone's thought on the Tyson Fury Klitschko rematch? And so, yes, we're in agreement, Zach. Lomachenko is unbelievable. Unbelievable. So, I'm going to throw out a hypothetical, because I'm a big boxing fan. I love boxing history. And if you guys can get it, there's a game called Title Bout. It is a boxing simulation game. Absolutely fun if you like to think about who would beat who. Again, doesn't mean it's accurate, but it's fun to simulate it. Who would win? Because I just saw Joshua fight, and I was a big Frank Bruno fan. How do you think that fight would go? Oh, Zach sends a message. You do realize Fury fight has been... No, I did not. Fury is claiming he has an injury. When did that happen, Zach? Thank you for the information. I was just watching a thing. You were talking about how it was coming up in 2 weeks. Oh, I got to check out Sky. Thank you for that information. Thank you very much. So... anyway, just throwing that out there to you, Zach, or any other UK fans or any other boxing fans. Joshua versus Frank Bruno in their primes. I don't know if Joshua's hit his prime yet, so, but we'll just say both in their primes, obviously, because, what, Frank Bruno's 50 years old and he just tried to get a boxing license again. I'm glad they didn't give it to him because I don't want to see him hurt. So. Alrighty, well, I'm going to probably sign off in a couple of minutes, but... I just want to get Zach's opinion on how he feels a Frank Bruno Anthony Joshua fight would go, and that would pack Wembley Stadium, wouldn't it? And Zach has informed me, and once I get off, I'm going to look it up, because I'm a little disappointed that that fight has been postponed. I was watching Showtime, and I thought they had mentioned it. Okay, Zach has just... message. He says, yep, Fury put the picks up yesterday morning. He's apparently got an ankle injury. Oh, wow. This is the second postponement of that fight. Am I correct there, Zach? Wasn't there a prior postponement? So. Anyhow, if you're joining us, right now I'm chatting with Zach. He's a boxing fan from the UK. I was doing a live reaction show to the Sean Porter-Keith Thurman fight that was on CBS here in the United States at the Barclay Center in Brooklyn, New York. We had a little more than 20 people at some times, and we were just chatting back and forth. Met some really nice boxing fans, Batman Boxing, Pasta Biceps Production, Ferdinand, Rico Suave. We're just having a good time. And right now I'm chatting with Zach, and we're just doing a little Tyson Fury, and he's informed me that the fight has been postponed again. And let me just read what Zach has messaged me, and I appreciate you messaging me, Zach. He said, yep, Fury... oh, that's the first one. Zach's replying back. I had put out to Zach who he thought would win a Bruno, Frank Bruno, Anthony Joshua fight.
And it's fun. I like to... it's fun to talk about that stuff. And Zach says, Bruno had the heart, but he isn't as good as Joshua. Yeah, he was much more mechanical. Joshua, very smooth, and from what I've seen of him, and just watching him today, and like I said, I watched... I've seen a couple of his fights on YouTube also. Very smooth fighter, so... what are your thoughts... Oh, another message from Zach. Everyone in the UK thinks Fury is making it up to wind up... Oh, wind up, sorry. Let me repeat that, Zach. Zach has messaged me again. He said, everyone in the UK thinks Fury is making it up to wind up Klitschko. He loves to get under Klitschko's skin. That's pretty funny. He is a character. He is a character. That's for sure. Tyson Fury is a character. Now, do you like him as a boxer, Zach? So, anyhow. Just curious, what is everyone's thoughts out there on Tyson Fury? I think he's good for boxing. I mean, he's a character. He had a tough fight with Cunningham in the U.S. Cunningham dropped him. I remember that. It was a really tough physical fight. But he used his size really good and wore him down and knocked him out. So. Anyhow, I think we're going to, as I've been on for an hour and 36 minutes, and the fight is over. But I am enjoying chatting with Zach. I keep debating whether to get off my broadcast here, and I'm so. This is Al Red Sox fan, and I have this is on Al Red Sox fan YouTube station. And if you'd like, check out the station. I do some fantasy boxing stuff on here. I've done a simulation of Frank Bruno and Henry Cooper, a simulation of Salvador Sanchez and Julio Cesar Chavez. I've done a simulation of Jake LaMotta versus Rocky Graziano, which is my audio call. I've also done a simulation of Primo Canera versus John L. Sullivan, which is my audio call, and some others. Lennox Lewis versus Riddick Bowe, I've done that simulation. So you can check that out if you'd like. Al Red Sox fan on Al Red Sox fan YouTube station. Zach sends another message. I honestly think Klitschko will win the rematch. Fury is good for boxing since Mayweather has gone. No more personalities left. I agree. Sometimes you do need the personalities. Well, all sports needs the personalities. But also... I'm going to tell you, Zach, what I really love about UK boxing. The passion of the fans. I love some of my most enjoyable things are when I can stream on my computer or even catch it on YouTube of when they do the British Commonwealth Championship fights. Unbelievable. Just the total... I mean, usually those fights, regardless of weight class, are really good fights and are entertaining to watch. I'm sure there's some stinkers, but they're fun to watch. And the fans, just the UK fans, are just unbelievable. And I just enjoy watching. I remember watching a fight with Nigel Benn. And I want to say the other fighter who was also from the UK was Lou Gent on ABC Wide World of Sports. And the atmosphere, the cheering, the singing was unbelievable. Just makes it so much fun. So, Lady Smiles. Hi, Al, Red Sox fan. No clue what you are talking about, but here, take my like. Thank you very much. We're just doing a little boxing talk. I was, we're doing a live reaction show of a boxing match, and that fight's over, and I'm just chatting away with Zach, who is a fan from the UK, boxing fan from the UK. Thank you so, Lady Smiles. Is this my YouTube friend? Now it just clicked. Is this my YouTube and Twitter friend from Korea? It just clicked with me. How are you doing? Hope all is well. What time is it there? Well, we've gone international. We got UK and we've got Korea, I believe. Awesome sauce. Alrighty. Anyhow, that's great. Well, I'm winding down here. Appreciate everyone who joined us. We did have a few people. We had close to, at one time, 25 people, which is a lot. That's okay if you don't know anything about boxing. Oh, it's so... Thank you for joining the chat there. So, love your stuff. You know I do. So, check out Soul Lady. She does wonderful reviews. I actually... My favorite reviews are when you're out and you're testing the sodas or the food. I love them. It is 12:48 p.m. in Sunday in Seoul, Korea. Well, I hope all is well there. Zach, I'm going to go on as it's almost 5 a.m. here. Zach, you're going to leave. Thank you very much, Zach. Appreciate your messaging. Thank you very much. Health and happiness to you, Zach, you and your family. Quick question. When does England play their next Euro game? No, Soul Lady. I love those. I love when you do the food and the soda and even your TV, your show reviews. But I'm being honest. I like the soda, the food stuff. That's more... I love it. So... And I can't wait till you do some more soon. Zach, wonderful that you joined us. And everyone who joined us and who's still watching. This is like addictive. I could stay on forever, but not going to. So, Soul Lady... anyone who's watching, check out Soul Lady Smiles on YouTube. She does, like I said, great reviews. Check her out. Subscribe to her channel. She's from Seoul, Korea. And it's fun. Also, to anyone else who's watching, shout out to Zach. Thank you very much for joining us. I hope he joins us again. And anyone else, feel free to join us when we once again do a live reaction of the boxing show. Thank you, Zach. They play on Monday. Okay. Oh! Well, Portugal won today, as you probably know. Viva Ronaldo. Portugal won right at the... beat Croatia right at the end, as you probably saw. Quick little soccer talk here. Croatia had three great opportunities in extra time, and they didn't get it done. And they... Ronaldo put the shot on net. The goalie made the stop, and I can't think of the player's name, but he headed it in. So, as you probably know, because you're a Portugal fan. So, alrighty, awesome. Well, on that note, I think I'm gonna sign off. This was a lot of fun. This is Al Red Sox Fan. If you like this, please subscribe to my YouTube. If you'd like, hit the share button, send it out. Leave me messages on my YouTube station or tweet me at Al Red Sox Fan. I'm a big boxing fan. I like to discuss a lot of things, but I'm a big boxing fan. So feel free. I like to meet new people. And if you'd like, subscribe. I'm trying to grow the station. If you have a YouTube station and you'd like my little help, I would love to tweet out your stuff. So, anyhow, Soul Lady Smiles. Yeah, I hope to catch another live thing, too. I will Google stuff, laugh out. Woo, soccer. I can understand. Oh, Quirzimo, he was the player who scored. Thank you very much, Zach. Thank you. All right. Awesome. I myself I'm an American, first generation, of Italian descent. So I'm rooting for Italy, but I also, my brother-in-law is Portuguese, so he's happy right now that Portugal won. I do root for the UK. I also do root for the UK. I follow the Premier League. That's my favorite professional soccer league. Is the Premier League. The Spanish, their first league. With Barcelona and Real Madrid. So, anyhow, I still have 7 people viewing me. I find that incredible that you've all suffered through me for this long on Gauntlet because I don't have a real camera yet. And I appreciate everyone who was watching. And just a couple of shout-outs here before I leave. Shout-out to my friend Zach here from the UK. Shout-out to Soul Lady in Korea. Yes, Italy versus Spain on Monday. Tough game. Tough game for Italy. Spain's always tough. Every team in this tournament's tough. It's all, you know, that's why they're there. They qualified. So, but yeah, I'll be rooting for, I'll be bringing my Kindle into work and sneaking a peek at the game. So, just to go back really quick, shout out to Zach from the UK. Thank you very much, for making it very enjoyable chatting back and forth. And Soul Lady from Korea, wonderful that you, joined me here in, she has a YouTube station, so check her out. She does really fun reviews on shows. And I'm going to be honest, Soul Lady, smiles, I love the reviews on the food and just like when you're just talking in general about Korea, South Korea. Shout out to Rico Suave. He joined us earlier in the broadcast when we were doing the live reaction of the fight. And also to Batman Boxing and Production. And Pasta Bicep and Ferdinand and everyone who joined. If I missed you, I apologize. It was fun. I didn't even expect to have, you know what, we had 20 something people. We enjoyed it. There's still 6 people viewing. Appreciate it. Lots of love to everyone. Health and happiness. God bless. Enjoy. God bless you. Take care. Love you all. Bye bye.